Hello, my name's David. In a recent video, we created a watermark, or it could have been a signature brush from a selection. This time, we're going to take a look at another method and one that has a surprising advantage, but more on that just a little bit later. For now, we're going to head up to File. We're going to go to New. When New Documents opens, Preset, Photo, using 3R, and it's 5 inches by 3.5 inches. Just make sure Transparent Background is ticked. Now click Create. Now, so as we can see the text we're going to apply, I'm going to go down to the bottom of the Layers panel and click on Add Pixel Layer. First of all, make sure you got the default colors. Any other colors, press D on the keyboard to restore those defaults. Now head up to Edit. We're going to go down to Fill with Secondary Color. So we've now got a black background. This will enable us to see the text. Talking of text, we're going to head over to Artistic Text Tool. Now when this opens, yes, I've got black here, so we're going to change it. Black on black just doesn't work. So I'm going to go down to white and just click to remove it. Now when I click down, I can drag this out. Now I'm going to use this for a signature brush. If you want to use it for a watermark or copyright brush, you need to enter that all important short code to give you the copyright symbol, and I will put those below for both PC and for Mac. Now I said signature brush, I'm just going to put my name in there. I'm going to pick up the move tool just so I can move it to the side so we can see what's going to happen. Because with a signature brush, it doesn't look particularly signature-like. So I'm going to highlight the text using the text tool. Now coming up to the top where we got the font, it's saying Arial. If I click down, notice the way it's highlighted. When you bring your cursor over the text, you can see the way it's going to change. Now if you're using it for a watermark, then something plain and simple will do, perhaps something like that. For a signature, you want something a little bit fancier. Now that's just a bit too fancy for me. If you know the name of the font that you want to apply, you can start typing it in. This is when it's highlighted at the top. So I'm going to H-A-N, there it is, that handwriting Dakota. I'm going to click on that one, clicking on the move tool and dragging it out in size. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is just add a little bit of a line underneath. So I'm going to click on the pixel layer. Once again, to add pixel layer, that is now underneath the text layer, and I'll explain why in just a moment. But for now, to the toolbox, I'm going to pick up the paintbrush. Make sure you got white as a foreground color, pressing X on the keyboard. Don't forget, you can also change it here as well. Now with the brushes, I'm on the basic brush panel, 16 pixels, that should be okay. Well, perhaps a little bit bigger, using the right hand square bracket to take it up in size. And I'm just going to do a little bit of an underline. Okay, why did we put this on a separate layer underneath? First of all, you need to make sure it's highlighted. That would really help. If you right click Merge Visible, that is not available if that pixel layer is above the text layer. That's the reason why. Command D, Control E is the shortcut. We can now click on our background layer. I'm going to press Delete. There's that checkerboard background. The next thing we need to do is head up to File. We're going to go down to Export. Now we're going to export it as a PNG file. That's my favorite format to use for this. There is the size of it. I'm going to export it to my desktop, and I'm going to call it something very simple, just SIG for signature. Right, pressing Save. We can close this down. We don't need that anymore. Let's take a look at this image. Now I want to apply my signature to this, so let's come to the brush panel, still on the basic tab. I'm going to change it to brushes. Don't forget, this is the category that we set up in the previous video. And if I just bring my cursor, I'm going to right click new image brush. If this fly up menu isn't available to you, head up to this very top little hamburger, click on that, and there it is, new image brush. Navigate your way to the where you stored it. I'm going to click on sig.png and click on open. It has arrived. Double clicking. Let's take the spacing up. Now you can see it. Size is only 64 pixels, so let's take this up in size. Something into this area here. That looks pretty good. Clicking close. Important thing, put in a pixel layer. So down to that add pixel layer once again. Now that we've done that, I'm going to press B on the keyboard, and there is the brush tool. I'm going to use the right hand square bracket to make it larger. Let's click down here, pressing H on the keyboard to give me back my hand tool. No, I'm not. I'm going to press V on the keyboard to give me the move tool. Because it's on a layer of its own, we can sort of make it bigger, we can make it smaller. Do not click on the background layer itself or on the image. So I'm going to place it here for the moment. Let's take a look. I want to add a little bit more detail to this. Or when I say detail, I want to give it a little bit more of a individual look. Let's have a look at 3D, tick in the box, taking the radius up. That looks pretty good like that. If you want to change the color, color overlay, there it is in black, but you can have any color you want. How about gray for this particular one? Let's do it in a light gray, just perhaps something like that will do. Okay, bit of a shadow, outer shadow, taking the radius up and taking the offset up like this. Don't forget, we can also change the angle. One thing I tend to do is go with the angle of the shadows in the image, but with this one, there aren't any. So let's click on close. Still got the move tool. Let's make it smaller. Let's drop it down into this bottom corner. That's where I'd place it. We can also just give it a little bit of a angle like that. I'll leave it like that. So I do normally use it a little bit smaller. Right, add new pixel layer. Let me show you one of the big advantages with this, pressing B on the keyboard, because it is an image brush, it's quite literally available in anything you want to do. So if you want to do your avatar, your emoji, fine. There it is with my logo, if it would stay still. Let's click down. It's now applied it. Full color, all the bits and pieces that I set up using Affinity Photo. Here's another one you might recognize, just bringing this out, using the right-hand square brackets. Just gonna place it on the same layer, but if we click down, there it is. This one has already got the bevel applied to it, pressing H on the keyboard in case I click down again. There it is. That's another method that we can use to create a signature or watermark as an image brush. Go on, give it a try. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Give it the thumbs up if you have, and don't forget to subscribe. Plenty more videos to come. Click that little bell icon. You'll receive a notification every time a new video is posted. But until the next time, it is Happy Imaging, and take care.